Before you read, the story we shall read is set in the future when books and schools as you now know them well perhaps not exist. So now what system we have? We go to school, we enjoy it a lot in school. But in future, what is going to happen? Everyone would be in the house only as we are today due to the current time. Okay? So in future also, because everyone is going to be so developed, so technical advanced, that everyone is going to stay in home and then only there will be education. How will children study then? The diagram below may give you some ideas. So here is a diagram which just gives you the idea that at that time how the students are going to learn. Learning through computers as you are doing now. Virtual classroom, okay, which seems to be with real classroom. Moving e-text, technological text, you don't have the books like in pages. Robotic teacher, in spite of being having human teacher, you will have the robotic teachers. So let's start with the chapter. Margie even wrote about it that night in her diary. On the page headed 17 May 2157, she wrote, "Today Tommy found a real book." So Margie is a girl, and in her diary she wrote that on 17th May 2157, this is a year when she noted down, it's a very special day for her. Why? Because her friend Tommy got a real book. They had never seen a real book in their life because they used to study from the computers. So it's a very great surprise for them. It was a very old book. Margie's grandfather once said that when he was a little boy, in his grandfather told him that there was a time when all stories were printed on paper. So Margie's grandfather's grandfather means great grandfather just told that when they were small, at that time they used to go to school and they had the book. They had the book and they used to study from the book. They turned the pages which were yellow and crinkly, and it was awful funny to read words that stood still instead of moving the way they were supposed to on a screen, you know. And then when they turned back to the page before, it had the same words on it that it had when they read it the first time. So what he says that those pages were very yellow. When we keep the books for a long time, it becomes yellow and it becomes very crinkly. Crinkly means it's already given here with many folds or lines. So it's very funny for Margie and Tommy to think that really they had the book like this and the words seems to be very still there and the book seems to be very yellow and cranky. So mark this line, yellow and cranky. Gee, said Tommy, what a waste. When you are through with the book, you just throw it away. So according to Tommy, it's a wastage. When you read the book, you throw it away. I guess our television screen must have had a million books on it, and it's good for plenty more. I wouldn't throw it away. So he says very proudly that their television means their computer screen has million books, and when they read, they don't throw it away. They have with them only. Same with mine, said Margie. She was 11 and hadn't seen as many tally books as Tommy had. So she was only 11 years old and she was younger than Tommy because Tommy was 13. So what she says that she might have not seen so many books as Tommy had. She said, "Where did you find it?" "In my house," he pointed without looking because he was busy reading. in the attic. So what he says, who found this book? Tommy found this book. And where he found? In his house. Okay. Attic is a place just below the roof. As a, or you may say it's just like a storeroom. So where he found it? At the attic in his house. What's it about? So Marie asked that the book is about what? So Tommy replied, it's about school. Margie was scornful. School? What's there to write about school? I hate school. So what Margie says that really it's very hatering for her. Or she said that yes, what's there to write about the school? She don't like. She hates school. Margie always hated school. But now she hated it more than ever. The mechanical teacher had been giving her test after test in geography and she had been doing worse and worse until her mother had shaken her head sorrowfully and sent for the count inspector. So now she don't like. Why she don't like now? Because the mechanical teacher or the robot teacher was giving her test after test, okay, and she is doing very poor in geography subject, okay, and that's why her mother was a little bit worried. Margie's mother was worried, and that's why she called county inspector to get it repaired. He was a round little man with a red face and a whole box of tools with dials and wires. He smiled at Margie and gave her an apple. Then took the teacher apart. So what he did, he, count inspector was a round little man, okay, with a red face and a, he had a box of tools with, in which he had dials and wires. So count inspector just smiled at Margie and he gave her an apple. And then he took his teacher. Who was the teacher here? Mechanical teacher, the robot. Margie had hoped he wouldn't know how to put it together again. But he knew how all right, and after an hour or so, there it was again, large and black and ugly, with a big screen on which all the lessons were shown and the questions were asked. So what he says that Margie had hoped he wouldn't know how to put it together again. So Margie hoped that the inspector, count inspector, don't know how to assemble it again, but he knew how all right, and after an hour or so, there it was again, large and black, ugly. But what happened? After an hour only, he had just repaired the mechanical teacher very well, and it was again ready to teach Margie. And the mechanical teacher was large, black and ugly with a big screen, because here, who is the mechanical teacher? A robot. On which all the lessons were shown and the questions were asked. So he says it's a big screen. It's a computer where a big screen was there and all the lessons were just taught to Margie.